Loss drugs Ozempic and Wegovy are wildly popular right now, but what are the side effects when it comes to your bones and muscles? U.S. Center for Sports Medicine orthopedic surgeon Dr. Rick Lehman joining us this morning to talk a little bit more about this. Good morning to you.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm good. I mean, so this is kind of a topic that's really fresh and new because these drugs are fairly new, right? So what do we know about the side effects?
Well, first of all, I think the drugs are very new, yeah. And it's taken the country over by storm, right? I mean, everybody is jumping on these drugs, people that need to lose 5 pounds or 100 pounds. And we don't really know very much. Right. So we're going to find out in the next 5 or 10 years, is this a great idea? Is this a terrible idea? But from an orthopedic standpoint of view, you have to think about it. You're losing weight, and you're losing mostly muscle mass. So you're relatively getting fatter, right? You're thinner, your weight's down, but your muscle, lean muscle mass is down. So your percentage of fat increases. Very weird concept. What do you have to do? You have to lift weights, and you have to train. You have to do cardio. And so all these women and men that are a little older that are not really used to activity need to bump up their resistance training and have to get in the gym.
So are you going to, in essence, avoid those side effects if you do that? Or not necessarily?
It's a great question. So the real question is, are you going to avoid the side effects, meaning is your lean muscle mass going to continue to go down? And we don't know.
Okay.
We really don't know. Now, the other side effects, which are real, are nausea, vomiting, loss of gastric emptying. So you can't lay down. You shouldn't lay down after you take the drugs. You should take the drugs before you eat, not after you eat. Mm-hmm. And generally, you have to really watch your diet. So the big problem is people get injected. They know they're going to lose weight. They eat whatever they want. They don't eat very much, but then they get these terrible side effects. And what are they? Nausea, vomiting, constipation, and they really are avoidable.
What food should they be eating? Should we all probably be eating, for that matter, right?
Well, that's really good. That's we should all be eating. So lots of lean protein. You can't eat greasy foods. You cannot do your Ozempic and then go have a pizza. You're going to get sick. Mm. You probably should eat grains. You probably should eat high fiber foods, lots of nuts, lots of berries. And you have to avoid simple carbs. So simple carbs, since you're not really digesting, you're not really emptying, when you eat simple carbs, that causes your blood sugar to go through the roof.
Do you see this changing through the years, or we're going to see really what the side effects are from this drug?
Well, we don't know. It's a little bit like COVID, right? Mm-hmm. We did all these vaccines, and now we're finding out what the side effects are. And we'll study this. Scientists will study this for 20, 30 years, and the drugs will change. So I think you're going to see a whole new group of drugs coming through the system, and they're going to address some of these side effects. But are we going to look back and say, wow, this created pancreatic cancer or this created thyroid problems? These are questions that are for the ages, and we don't know. The big problem is going to be it's going to be too late once we figure this out. But again, all these drugs are so new, we really don't have a track record.
Yeah, there's a report just, I think, last week about people taking Ozempic who were, it was kind of knocking out the birth control pill, that they were finding themselves getting pregnant even though they were taking the pill.
Well, when you think about it, it's something called a GLP-1 inhibitor. So it's going to mimic insulin. It's a hormone. It's a protein. And we don't really know what all the other things that have to coexist, right? Your hormone levels, your estrogen levels. And there is a real problem if you're taking birth control pills and you are on these weight loss drugs. Well, there's two problems. One is, yes, you can still get pregnant, and you need to be aware of that. And two, we're seeing a lot of people that take these drugs, and then they have an injury, a surgery, an injury, and they don't heal. Why? Because they've lost so much nutrition that their ability to heal wounds, you're seeing people with their hair falling out. So again, your nutrition is really important. So when you start taking these drugs, you're going to eat less, but you better be paying attention to what you're eating.
All right. Some good stuff for us this morning. Dr. Lehman, thank you so much.
Thank you.